Medical school lasts about 4 years, which is typically done after a pre-med degree, and it's followed by a residency and a fellowship. Now, this can definitely be overwhelming, and it is a huge and long process if you think about it. MD Edits Consulting does a great job helping students who want to go into med school. Now, they start all the way from like primary applications to secondary applications, and the best part and the thing that makes them so unique is that these are current students who've been accepted into some of the best programs in the United States as well as Canada, who help other students reach similar goals. So before I start this video and we dive right into what 4 years of medical school looks like in the US, I wanna give a huge shout out to these guys. If you wanna check them out, they provide free 15-minute consultation to kind of like answer any preliminary questions that you might have. And all of their programs, if you guys are watching this video, you are eligible to get 10% off using the discount code Saloni10. So I'm gonna leave that in the description below. Definitely check that out. So there are certain specializations that you can get into, like surgical programs and medicine. And this is basically what residency revolves around. You learn how to take histories, take physicals, and build diagnosis. And essentially, you learn the ins and outs of the field that you're interested in. The idea is to learn procedures and better yourself so that you can be a successful physician in the future after you graduate from that med school program. Now, apart from these two specializations, some of you may be more interested in research, for example, oncology and other fields out there. So this is typically followed by a fellowship after med school that you can get into so you can focus on your research as well as be a physician. Now, to make things simple, the 4 years of medical school in the US are typically broken down into two categories, preclinical and clinical training of medical school. So let's talk about the preclinical, which is years 1 and 2. Now, to kind of like break this down even further, year 1 is where you study about fundamental concepts and physiology. Basically, you learn how everything works. And year 2 is where you learn how to treat something if something goes wrong, so more towards pathology. Now, with the current like changes to education systems being done throughout, what's being talked about is potentially integrating these 2 years into a 1.5-year program so you can get more clinical training in your second half of med school. So in the first 2 years of medical school, you do a ton of case-based learnings. These are basically like group assignments that you do in groups of 5 or 6 people where you're given a particular case for you to observe, find a solution, and then present that solution. And this essentially consists of you analyzing the whole problem statement, studying and learning lecture notes to see what the potential diagnosis could be, studying images, and everything revolving around that case. You have about a week to learn up that lecture and your proposed diagnosis to the entire group. And after that, you present your case to everyone else. This is kind of like preparing you for a real life scenario so that you can be more confident in your findings as well as learn those concepts and get like exposure to real life scenarios. The other interesting thing that you may be exposed to during your first 2 years of medical school are shadowing and preceptorships. Now, the whole idea here is you shadow someone who's already a physician in an area of specialty that you're interested in, the goal being to see if you enjoy that field and if you can see yourself practicing that after you graduate. And this is also very interesting because the whole concept is to see where you're comfortable and you enjoy what you do. So that kind of like wraps up the gist of years 1 and 2. Let's jump right into the USMLE. Now, in the USMLE, there are 4 exams. Step 1 is generally taken after year 2 of med school, and this kind of comprises of everything you've learned in years 1 and 2. The exam itself is pretty comprehensive. It's about 7 hours long, and it tests your clinical knowledge as well as basic science abilities. It's a very like simple pass or fail test, and with that, you move on to USMLE Step 2. Now, USMLE Step 2 is divided into 2 parts, clinical skills and clinical knowledge. Clinical skills is a comprehensive exam which tests your clinical maneuvers and your ability to make a diagnosis. It's typically taken after the 4th year of med school, after you apply for your residency program. It's again a pass or fail test, and with the changing education systems, this part of the USMLE may even be phased out in the next few years. Now we move on to the clinical knowledge part of step two. This is again a pretty comprehensive exam, which is very similar to the MCAT, and these scores determine what type of residency program you'll get into. With that, the last and final step is the USMLE step three. So step three of the USMLE is the last step, and it's generally taken during the first year of your residency. The questions in step three reflect more towards the specialty that you actually want to pursue as a physician. So they'll be more tailored towards the area that you're interested in and actually chose after graduating from med school. So that kind of wraps up the whole USMLE, debacle. And I've made an entire video on this topic, explaining more in detail the processes, the steps, how Indian graduates, Indian physicians can also come to the US and practice medicine. So if you're interested in that, definitely check out this other video after you complete watching this one. So now let's jump back into years three and four of your med school journey. Now, year three is basically all about clerkship. Clerkship is you do co-rotations and rounds, and basically different med schools, different residency programs, should I say, have different criteria towards the number of hours they need for this clerkship. So once you kind of like start prepping your list, do your own research to find out what your programs require so that you can fulfill those in your clerkship hours in year three of med school. So after the core rotation, there is something called a shelf exam, which is associated by the National Board of Medical Examiners. This is an exam that consists of roughly 110 questions related to the specialty that you just worked in. And this brings us to year four, which is the final year of your med school journey. I know, right? We're almost closing in, almost getting done with the whole med school student journey. But this is full of electives, so you have a lot more room to play around with what you're actually interested in, and you can take as many electives as you like in the area that you're actually interested in. Now, the interesting thing about year four is 36 of the 52 weeks in a year need to be spent doing clinical rotations or clinical training, but the other time you can spend doing research, USMLE prep, and basically applying to other residency programs. So Dr. Crowley from Harvard Medical School pointed out two interesting things. If you're a student who's thinking about going into med school, you really need to assess your academic aptitude and your emotional resilience to see if this is the right career path for you or not. So with this in mind, I also want to point out that med school does require your undivided attention. So juggling this with a part-time job or another career is definitely not something that's advised. Once students reach clinical rotations, their schedules are extremely unpredictable and so irregular. So being able to adapt is key to winning in a stressful situation. Now, I think it's important to bring your A game on rotations and clerkships because program directors are carefully watching and assessing students to ultimately make the decision for who gets into their residency programs. I have a whole separate video on the best pre-med degrees out there. If you're a potential student looking into going into med school, so definitely check that out. The US does require a four-year undergraduate degree as a pre-med degree before you can go into medical school. So you need to make sure that you fulfill this prerequisite before applying. So a huge factor that goes into any student's decision of pursuing medicine is the time and effort that's spent during actually going into becoming a physician. You spend close to 10 years. And, you know, to kind of like look at the situation as glass half full, you can see that being a physician and actually practicing medicine once you finish your training, you'd be doing that for a longer time compared to the educational training that you go through. So while this is, you know, a challenging career path, it's definitely rewarding in the end. Now, I'm not a medical student or a physician in any way, but as a biomedical engineer and, you know, doing a deep dive into this field, I feel like the hardest and the key moments of medical school are also some of the most challenging and the most important moments, because that's when a student transitions from fundamental theoretical knowledge into actual hands-on clinical rotations and training. And this is where students learn how to diagnose as well as cure diseases in the real life world. So with all that said, I want to end this video on a very positive note that Well, kind of positive. The hardest part of med school in general is actually getting in. And I think that this isn't said enough, but there are so many people out there to help you. Whether you're in school, undergrad, or even like an early young professional who's looking into going into medicine, you have counselors, advisors, career advisors, people just there who can talk you through this, share their experiences, and videos like mine who help you, you know, make the right and informed decision into your career path. So definitely reach out to everyone that you can, who can help you make this decision in your career and on your journey. And that's about it for this video. So if you like this video and you're watching till this very point, smash that thumbs up button, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, hit that notification bell so you don't miss any weekly uploads that I put out on the channel. And I'll see you guys next week in another video. Till then, take care. Bye.
Today, you are the doctors. You will be pushed to the breaking point. Look around you. Say hello to your competition.